10 laps in length, makes up the distance of these heat races, taking the top nine finishers here in heat race number one. Michael Chilton jumps into the early lead, Shannon Buckingham in second. As we got a bad start somewhere. In heat race number one, Michael Chilton jumps into the early lead, Shannon Buckingham in second. As we got a bad start somewhere. And we're underway once again, 10 laps make up the distance of this heat race. Michael Chilton jumps into the early lead, Shannon Buckingham in second, Skyler Marler in third, Tripp Gerald in the fourth position, Billy Ogle Jr. in fifth, here comes Tommy Kerr back to the fifth or sixth, Mark Douglas in the sixth position, Tommy Kerr in seventh, Brandon Overton in eighth, and Brad Skinner in the ninth position. Chilton is your early leader. We are lined up number two. Now the car taking a look to go to the featured race. David Crabtree right on the back of Brad Skinner. That's a battle for position. That is a battle for transfer position. We are four laps into this 10 lap heat race for the Super Late Models here at Smoky Mountain Speedway. Brandon Overton's found his speed coming down the back straightaway. He's moving up positions now. He's now in the fifth position. Billy Ogle Jr. in sixth, Tommy Kerr seventh, Mark Douglas eighth, Brad Skinner in the ninth and final transfer position. Chilton continues to be your leader. Buckingham in second. Skyler Marler in the third position. Comes Michael Chilton. He's going to take the win, put himself on the third row inside for the feature race coming up. Shannon Buckingham in second, Skyler Marler and Brandon Overton finishing third and fourth. Tripp finished fifth, Billy Ogle Jr. sixth, Tommy Kerr seventh, Mark Douglas eighth, and the number nine car, the ninth place car, and taking the final transfer spot, the number 17 of
Overton.
Yeah, he was. Green flag this time by. We are underway. Ricky Weiss dives under Robbie Moses for the fourth position. You got your two leaders out front. Here comes Donald McIntosh as he powers to the lead coming out of turn number four. Brian Ligon slows a little bit in the corner. That allows Ricky Weiss to grab the third position. Brian Ligon in the fourth position. Carter Miller. In the fifth position, Robbie Moses, sixth. Mark Field, seventh. David Brazil in the eighth position. Bobby Giffen in the ninth position. Tommy Taylor grazes the wall here on lap number six. Tommy Taylor in the number 10 car. He's in the 10th position. Kane Hickman in the 9th position. And Carter. And the number 7 car of Craig Greer. McIntosh picks up the win. Casey Roberts in second. Ricky Weiss in third. Brian Ligon in fourth. Robbie Moses fifth. David Brazil sixth. Mark Field seventh. Bobby Giffen in the eighth position in rounding out the final transfer spot. The number 10 of Tommy Taylor. And that'll do it for our heat races with the super late model class. As we're looking for the green flag this time by, we are underway. Dale McDowell jumps into the lead. Mike Marler in second, Chris Ferguson in third. Skip Art finds his way, moving the back, towards the back of the pack as Donald McIntosh and Michael Chilton just about gets him. Here comes Chris Ferguson to the inside of Donald McIntosh. He's going to take third away from McIntosh. McIntosh back to fourth. Then Skip Arp is fifth. Bobby Giffen sixth. Michael Chilton seventh. Casey Robertson seventh. Brandon Overton eighth. Ricky Weiss in ninth. And rounding out your top 10 will be the number 50 of Shannon Buckingham. The 52D of Mark Douglas slows on the front straightaway. He's going to make that hard left-hand turn as he pulls his car into the infield pit area. Dale McDowell is your leader. Mike Marter in second. Chris Ferguson in third. Donald McIntosh in fourth. Skip Arp in fifth. Michael Chilton in sixth. Then you have the number 101 of Casey Roberts in seventh. Brandon Overton in eighth, Ricky Weiss in ninth, Shannon Buckingham in tenth, and the number four car, Brad Legan, in the top 10. Coming upon slower traffic, Dale McDowell, and we got a car, Mark Fields, in the 26F car pulls into the infield pit area. Dale McDowell now coming slowly among the slow markers here tonight. Dale McDowell puts the 97 of Bobby Giffen a lap down. He now, and also the 11 of Skyler Marler, pulls this car into the infield pit area. The 10 of Tommy Taylor goes a lap down by Dale McDowell. And Taylor, oh! Donald McIntosh. As we are underway, Dale McDowell again blows into the lead. Chris Ferguson in second, Donald McIntosh third, Michael Chilton in fourth, and Casey Roberts in the fifth position. Here comes Brandon Overton in fifth, Casey Roberts back to sixth, Ricky Weiss in seventh, Shannon Buckingham in eighth, Brian Legan in the ninth position, Robbie Moses in 10. McDowell with a good lead as we're coming by. This time click on lap number 13. Chilton now has gotten by the number seven of Donald McIntosh. Chris Ferguson in second, Michael Chilton third, Donald McIntosh in fourth, Brandon Overton in fifth, Casey Roberts in sixth, Ricky Weiss in seventh, Shannon Buckingham in eighth. Brian Legan in ninth. Tripp Gerald in the 10th position. Trip Gerald and Brian Ligon battling it out. Thank you.
Kinzer Drilling Company, Clements House of Power, Quality Natural and Gas. Talking here with brother team owner Shane McDowell of Shane McDowell Racing. And he's fixing to climb out of car number 17M. The flag-to-flag winner for $7,500 in the spring shootout. Put your hands together, Dale McDowell! Brother, congratulations, the big winner here tonight. The car seemed like it was flawless from start to finish.
Well, it was. Shane and Jimmy and old man and their Kinzer's guys helped us out there a lot, and so we made good adjustments, and I didn't hit anything tonight. They've been giving me a hard time, so I was going to run out of rivets because we tore some stuff up, but really like this place. It was awesome fast tonight, and talked to Dave, and I know he had his hands full after it rained. I had the same thing going last night at Boyd's. You know, after it rains, the racetracks, they just get fast, so hats off to those guys for working hard. Thanks to all the race fans, and thanks everybody who put this race on.
This new partner guys got with Brandon Kinzer and the whole Kinzer family at Eastern Kentucky, just a great partnership, and then the new partnership there with your brother taking over that team, and you guys found something that's just clicked and worked, and seems like all the pieces are falling together for you guys.
Well, I mean, hats off to my brother he's my boss now, so but for Jerry and Brandon and all the Kinzer family to come on, New Era Industrial and Will Kinzer Foundation, Kinzer Drilling, Klotz Kometic, it takes everybody, you know, Boyd Speedway, it takes everybody to make this program go. Shane took it up on his own to let us get out here and do this. And he and Sarah, she'll remind me of that. So but he and Sarah did that. So I've been at the racetrack a lot and have been working on this stuff. So credit goes to them. I'd have tailed it between the walls.
Good job tonight. We'll let you catch your breath and enjoy victory lane.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Tonight's winner, Dale McDowell in 17M. Get a quick word with tonight's runner-up. And, man, that car just came on fire with about 10 laps to go. Second place, Donald McIntosh. And good run for that Blunt Motorsports Rocket tonight.
We had a good car. It was a little snug in the center and up there on top. That's just not my comfort zone, man. I was following them and following them and following them, and finally I got tired enough. I'm like, I got to try the bottom. Whether I go backwards or forwards, I'm going to hit the wall or one. So when I went to the bottom, the car started working really good down there. So I can't thank these guys enough. This car's been great. This racetrack was very physical tonight. David had it wide open for all of us, but it was a great night. I can't thank Larry Garner and, you know, everybody that allows me to do this. It's pretty awesome. Penske Shocks, Vic Hill Race Engines, Rocket Chassis, Massey Electric, Tennessee RV, Stowers Cat, and everybody that's a part of this race team. Eric Watson and Taylor Watson and all the gang that's helped us on this car has really made a big deal for us.
You had a good run there. We made before the 10 to go mark, where you were able to get around for the second spot there. We had a good run going with Michael Chilton as well in the 97 car.
Yeah, no doubt. I'd get a run on him, and I'd lose the nose with the air. And I was like, dang, because every time he'd make a mistake is when I had just previously made a mistake and couldn't capitalize on it. But, yeah, it was a good race. I mean, for as fast as it is, it was a good race.
All right, second place tonight, Donald McIntosh. North Carolina. Chris Ferguson coming home third tonight at Smoky Mountain at a track that you like getting over here to every once in a while, getting a run over here on this big half mile.
Yeah, I enjoyed it a lot. The track was phenomenal tonight. It was really fast the whole race, but, man, we was all over it. Me and Donald swapped lanes that first restart. You know, then he got by me in traffic, but can't say enough. The track was awesome tonight. You know, we didn't tighten up enough. I think once that track blacked over a little bit, we just couldn't hang with Dale. But, it's just fun coming up here, and says a lot about our team. We went through a lot this year, and to come back up here with the caliber of cars and be this good and qualify and practice and race good, it says a lot. So I hate that for Mikey. You know, I think it was going to be a good race with him and Dale and Doug Lowe just to miss that. But, it's a fun race.
I was going to say, you guys went through little ups and downs with the team, but you guys able to bounce back with that podium finish tonight. As you mentioned, it says a lot for your team and what you guys are progressing towards. So it seems like you guys are on the uphill slide right now.
Yeah, definitely. Thank my crew guys for all the hard work. You know, them Brandon Tadpole, Dr. Blake, Jordan, Drew Tanner, all them guys, Dad, you know, and all my sponsors. I got three of my big sponsors with me tonight, and they rode up in the truck with us. So I think they had a good night tonight, and we did too. We can bring the car home in one piece and beat the right rear quarter panel out and go again next week.
All right, third place tonight here at Smoky Mountain, Chris Ferguson.